The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but are underneath are ravenous wolves. By their fruits you will know them. Do people pick grapes from thorn bushes or figs from thistles? Just so, every good tree bears good fruit, and a rotten tree bears rotten fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a rotten tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. So by their fruits you will know them." The Gospel of the Lord. Recently on the news, there was a story showing a four-year-old boy named Austin Perrin, 3 feet tall, but he was noted as a superhero to many homeless people in Birmingham, Alabama. Some may have seen this story. Austin wears a red satin super cape because he says it blows in the wind and makes him go faster. But the little boy's superpower is kindness. Ever since his dad explained to Austin about homelessness, Austin has made it his mission to feed the hungry in his hometown. Every week, Austin dons his red cape to hand out chicken sandwiches and cold drinks at a homeless shelter where people come for lunch. Austin's efforts were noted by a restaurant. He began doing this charity work on his own, without any inspiration from anybody else, using his own allowance. This restaurant noticed his good deeds and gave him $1,000 a month for a year in order to supersize the project, to help him to continue to reach out to others. His superhero motto, emblazoned on his blue t-shirt, says, "Show love." That's what our gospel calls us to do today, to show love. The Old Testament reading from the second book of Kings tells us the story of the discovery of the book of Deuteronomy found in the temple when the temple was being redone. All the people of that time had begun to weaken in their faith, and so they gathered together to listen to the word of God found once anew in the temple. And once the word of God was proclaimed to them, they recommitted themselves to their faith. In the gospel, we hear that our commitment to our faith must show itself in word and actions. And so we come together today in prayer so that we may recommit ourselves to our faith. Once we have made this recommitment in this Eucharist today, we go forth to show the good fruit that our faith has given to us in our belief in God, and to share that good fruit with others by demonstrating God's kindness, his compassion, his generosity, his forgiveness, and his peace. Once again, the Lord calls us to put into action the faith that we have received. And today we commit ourselves to doing just that.